Well, hello there. My name is James Flaskamp, and today I'm going to show you the process of creating an IFTTT applet, which thankfully is a very simple process. So, the first step in the process is to log into your IFTTT account, which you see I have done here. Step two is to use the drop-down menu to choose New Applet. Now the interface is set up with the phrase if this then that, which is what IFTTT stands for, and so step three is to click this and choose a service and then log in to connect to the service if necessary. So the applet I'm going to create is one using Wikipedia, so I'm going to start typing that in and then I'm going to choose Wikipedia. Now this is the point where if this were a service that needed to be that required a login, I would have to log in, but Wikipedia obviously doesn't require that, so I don't need to log in to connect to the service in this case. The word of the day is what I want to use in my applet, so I'll click word of the day. This is the trigger that I'm choosing, so this is step four in the process. And so the word of the day, I want it in English, and then I will click Create Trigger. So you see Wikipedia populates the then part of the equation, and now we have that to deal with, which is step five. So we'll click on that, and now we'll choose the service that we're going to link to Wikipedia's word of the day. And in this case, I want it to be a Google spreadsheet. I want a new entry in a Google spreadsheet whenever Wikipedia posts its word of the day. So I will click that. I'll choose this service, Google Sheets. And I don't have to log in right now because I have logged in to this before, but you may have to log in to connect to the service. And then I will choose this action. This is step six. I'll choose add row to spreadsheet, and everything looks good. The spreadsheet name, formatted row, folder path, this all looks fine to me, so I'll go ahead and click create action. This is step seven in the process, and that brings us to our final step in the process, which is to review what we've done and simply click finish. I can click this if I want to, you know, disable notifications when the applet runs. It's not necessary for me, so I did disable it, and now I'll click the finish button. And just like that, I have created a new applet.